Parts of the U.S. could see the Northern Lights today. That'd be cool, thanks to a severe solar storm, and that could include Northern California.
Well, the Space Weather Prediction Center says that at least 5 coronal mass ejections have been directed toward Earth. I don't even understand that, but it sounds cool. If they're strong enough, the storms could impact infrastructure and could also trigger those colorful auroras.
So awesome. Dirk Verdorn, talk to us about the possibilities.
Oh yeah, let's talk about those possibilities. This is kind of neat to watch. This is something that happens all the time. But let's go ahead and talk about the sun. And again, never look directly at the sun. But if you get out your eclipse glasses this afternoon to look at the sun, you can. You might be able to put that filter over, and you can see sunspots. Yeah, there are some sunspots there. We're at a solar maximum. That means there's a lot of sun storm activity going on, and you can see those little storms, those magnetic storms on the sun as sunspots. These storms, they sit there and they wind up, basically. Take a rubber band, you kind of twist it until finally there gets to be so much energy that it just gets released. And when it gets released, and all that matter from the surface of the sun, or some of it, a little bit of it, gets shot out into space. And so the sunspot that we're interested here is 3664. And you can see it's a pretty big complex there, that sunspot is. And it's pointed in the general direction of the Earth. And it recently, as you mentioned, had 5 coronal mass ejections. So it wound up 5 times and shot charged particles into space, and those charged particles, at least part of it, is coming towards the Earth. Now, this will affect us. It can affect our power systems. We can have blackouts associated with this. That's happened in the past. Spacecraft operations have to be altered. It can affect satellites as well as the astronauts up in the ISS, and so they have to be concerned about this as well. Navigation equipment is affected by this. Radios are affected by this, but also it creates aurora, and this is really interesting because this is something that just everybody can hopefully enjoy if you're in that area. So what area do you need to be in? Well, the forecast for right now, you can see that the aurora are up in Canada and across Alaska. Now, tonight, when these coronal mass ejections or these charged particles hit the Earth, they get, again, drawn towards the poles, and that energy creates more aurora, and it goes into lower latitudes. And so you can see here, this red line is what's called the view line. And the forecast from NOAA now has it going into Oregon, pretty much covering all of Oregon and into northern Utah, Wyoming, Nebraska, Iowa, Illinois, all these areas, all the way up into New York. Most of New York should be able to see it. So New York City, you get away from the city lights and you can see some aurora possibly tonight. So this is going to be the bigger one, but we could still see it tomorrow night as well in those northern states from Washington through northern Idaho, Montana, North Dakota, Minnesota. The chance for that's going to still be there, but it's not going to be as strong. And so the reason why the first wave that's coming through tonight is so much stronger is that there's a cannibal CME. This is interesting. You had the first 2 ejections that happened, and they were moving along, but the third one that came out was a bigger one, and so it was moving faster, and it catches up to the first 2 and kind of gobbles them up. And so that's why we have a stronger one coming tonight, and then the other one that's going to continue on into tomorrow. So, I don't know, just interesting stuff. That's
awesome. I feel like I could actually pass the pop quiz.
No, I think so, too. We need to get you some styrofoam planets that you can, like, move around. That's actually awesome. That's great. Thank you, Dirk.